and action.
I think everyone's formative period is their teenage years. For me, it was the late 70s and early 80s. The music of that period, the movies of that period. I've always looked for a way to try to address that time. That was my time. Even though I don't feature in the movie as a character, those memories are very personal.
It's 1981, which involves quite a lot of 1970s leftovers. So there's some fantastic costumes wandering around. Big hair.
Don't you look absolutely glorious?
Very.
So I had a Zoom during lockdown with Sam. He said, I'm thinking of writing this film and I'm thinking of you to play a part in it. And I said, yes, please. And turns out the script was really good.
I thought it had real life to it. It felt truthful.
And the writing really transports you into the era of the piece.
Wow, what a place.
It really was beautiful.
It still is.
Sam's director's style, he can communicate very, very well, which I love. It makes it so much easier as an actor to not be thinking about so much things that a director is saying.
Thank you, that's all I wanted to get.
He is so emotionally engaged. He knows exactly what to say so that you understand what he wants. If it's sad, he's crying. If it's funny, he giggles behind the monitor.
Goes without saying that he's just able to notate actors in ways that are always useful and sensitive to what the actor is trying to do.
Thank you.
The main character is Hillary. She's living with mental health issues.
Growing up around my mother, who was disintegrating mentally, was something, I suppose, that formed me. And a lot of those memories have gone into the way that we render Hillary.
It's a very warm portrait of a woman, you know, who is really a lost soul, but finds a strange family within the cinema.
She has been embraced by this eccentric bunch.
Thank goodness you're here, because I need some of this cake!
Ta-da! Safeway's finest.
Everyone that I've been able to work with closely has been incredible, and we're all just on a journey. Just learned so much from each and every one of them in different ways.
Just sit in the middle of a bunch of people who don't know you, who've never met you, who can't even see you.
You know, I've spent most of my adult professional life sitting in dark auditoria of various kinds. This is my home, you know, and then sitting alone as an audience member, losing myself. That little beam of light is escape. You know, I believe that.
What?
Show me a film. I want to see a film.
It's a romance about a love of one character for another. It's a romance about a love of this particular world, about the beauty of the idea of cinema.
It's not the size of the screen so much, it's whether you get a jump scare at the same time as 200 other people, or whether you cry at the same time as 200 people. If we're not going out and congregating, there's probably a commonality that we're depriving ourselves of. I hope people come and see this film in that spirit.